Hi everyone, Alfred here from Alfred.tv. Wow, look at the delivery of the opening. Not even one smirk or a stumble or a stutter or a stammer. Nice. It's December 24th, 2014. It's the morning of Christmas Eve. Let's do a weather status check from the beachside balcony. Oh, and without doubt, it's an absolutely glorious day. Glorious day. Let's do an ancillary weather check. Hey Siri, what's the weather like?
The weather looks good today. Up to 81 degrees Fahrenheit and partly sunny. Well, it looks like a pretty mixed bag tomorrow through January 2nd, 2015, with a high of 79 and a low of 63 degrees.
What can I say but nice? But let's set it like a winter wonderland in the condo. As such, we proceed to the wonderful nest, and let's just set this bad boy down to, 54 looks, that's good. That's good, I like that. I wish it was 34. I do want to document the beautiful, lovely plant that Coupon Karen and my brother Gary got me, but there's a backstory behind it. I just opened it. Karen shipped it over 2 weeks ago. She hollered at me, "Didn't you see the sign? It said like live plant." I don't know, it was in with like 900 other Amazon boxes. So, late unboxing, but I'm very proud to say that I didn't kill a freaking plant. It's resting comfortably on the balcony. No, I'm not going to edit that out. Anyway, I have to wrap stuff because I'm really way behind. Let's look at the pile. So, except the Titanfall for the Xbox One that I never opened, everything else is gifts for the family members down here and for the gang up north. Obviously, the gifts, not JPEGs, for the gang up north is... are going to come late, but I mean, at least it's consistent with what I've been doing for the past several years. My Christmas tree is up, the Philips USB Christmas tree, and since it's on top of it, the Mac Pro is technically acting as the base for my Christmas tree, and this overly expanded Mac Pro at about $10,000. This makes it, without any doubt, the most expensive Christmas tree collectively. Yes. Unbelievable, folks. Use your Mac Pro as a base for your next Christmas tree. Philips USB powered tree. It's just, like I say, it's fucking festive. I do buy Christmas gifts for over 50 people, family members and friends. And I'm very thankful that I have the ability to do that and such a wonderful group of family members and friends. This year, I'm up to 22 Swarovski crystals. Yes, I've been practicing to say Swarovski. Let's point camera 3 at the beachside unboxing stove. And what an old school stove it is. So there's the pile of the Swarovski crystals, which will be wrapped in aluminium as the shout out to my friends and viewers in the UK and other parts of the world that say aluminium. Now, I purchased those crystals in October. Yes, I did something early, though they're shipping late. I bought them early in October. I think they cost me about $60 each. Let's go to Amazon.communist and see what they cost now, the day before Christmas. And there you have it. Prices ranging from $119 all the way up to $139. So there's a lesson in economics, kiddies. It's called supply, demand, and when you order the day before Christmas, you're gonna get fucked on these things. And I just got a group text message from the family members down here with regard to the schedule. Let's take a look at what the message is. So the message reads with a beautiful icons and graphics, Happy Christmas. Christmas Eve festivities will begin at 2 p.m. - crappetizers. Dinner at 4 p.m. Santa arrives by 6:30 to 7 p.m. Ho, 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 see you soon. And let me show you my video response.
Well, I'm starting to wrap gifts, everyone. Yeah, there's the pile. Not sure, it should be in the camera frame. And, dinner's at 4, so I'll be there at 3:59. Nice.
Anyway, let me wrap the Swarovski... I did fuck it up. Let me wrap the Swarovski... Should I edit this? Let me wrap the Swarovski... I still have trouble saying that freaking word! let me wrap the Swarovski crystals that I'm going to be bringing to the family members down here first and get that out of the way. It's really kind of easy. You know, I almost forgot. I started wrapping these freaking things. Let's take a look at what the gift looks like. Let's look at the 2014 Swarovski crystal. Of course, once again, fine Alfred.tv cinematography. I'm framing it with this Think Geek light-up thing. I think it's called the Jellyfish, which is kind of cool. But yeah, the crystal is absolutely beautiful, the 2014 Swarovski crystal. And now that I'm buying so many of them, I think I should become like an authorized dealer slash distributor. Oh, and look at this. Only the best for the Alfred.tv viewing audience. Let's do the pan shot. And once again, look at the cinematography here that I do for you all. The official LED Christmas lights are on the beachside unboxing stove. And there you have 70 of these beautiful crystals wrapped for some of the family members down here in South Florida. Now, what you'll notice, a technique here, that some of the product is exposed, the gift is exposed. I look at this as just adding color to the wrap job. Notice the wonderful texture, which as it sits under the tree, it will indeed glisten quite well. And certainly, we want to give a shout out to the engineers and technicians at NASA. The Apollo space mission gave us aluminium foil. We like that. By the way, one of my favorite peripherable, yes, I said peripherable is a joke, is the Dymo thermal underwear, thermal laser, that doesn't even make any sense. Everything at Alfred.tv, wrong information. Dymo thermal label printer. And if I was, did a yank onto the floor. And yes, some lovely labels that I made for those crystals. And if I can show you just the moniker that's put on, you know, like I said, he is to Madeline Jr. You know, we add the ho 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 on there for the subliminal ho reference, and the girls know it, and they get a little pissed off, and then they laugh, but it's all in good fun. Ho. Okay, so the set of South Florida Swarovskis are ready to rock and roll. As such, we're on to our next item. Of course, keep in mind that sometimes big things, or relatively big things, can come indeed in small packages. As such, to cousins Mike and Rich, it gets a merry freaking Christmas. And inside these very, very small envelopes are nice FF class $100 home creepo cards. But how do we enhance the way this looks to make it a true Alfred.tv class gift wrap? Let me show you. And the solution is very simple. We adorn the envelope with a One Direction duct tape. I don't believe they make this shit. I don't believe people buy this shit. And there you go. very, very freaking festive One Direction, and whatever. Okay, this is an art piece for Alex Lights. It's an art piece designed by this artist named Brito. And while I like the pieces, but this is the guy responsible for defacing Dolphin Stadium. So if you want to see what I'm talking about, just Google, you know, Brito and then Dolphin Stadium or something like that. But the piece, it's a frog. All right, Alex has like a frog fetish. And he collects a lot of frog pieces, him and his wife. I have a LeBron 11 and LeBron 12 sneaker fetish. I guess to each his own, right? Actually, let me show you the boxes. Yeah, these are some new ones that I got in for myself. That's six of them right there. And a bunch more in my inventory. And yes, I wear a size 10 and a half. So if you have a nice LeBron 11 or 12 you'd like to gift me, let it rock. So back to the piece. Let's wrap this thing. Hopefully we don't crack party. We don't crack the handles. Putting the styrofoam back in. Hopefully I don't knock it on the tile floor. And yeah. All right. So phase one mission accomplished. Hey, I'm not gonna attempt to wrap that box. Why wreck the beauty of the packaging? Though I will wreck it with the stickers I'm gonna put on it. But that looks really nice, and it doesn't really identify what's inside. The box is like generic box. So let me just adorn it with a few official Alfred.tv items to make it special. Okay, so we dress it up with a purple Halloween duct tape. I think the purple goes well with the black. We have the artist, and we have the shout out to Joey D for the and. We have the artist Brito, and then we say that, yes, Brito defaced Dolphin Stadium, and then a shout out to a great Papa Pump. We mark it as to Alex from Alfred for your fetish, and then of course the official. We've got to be, hopefully we don't break the piece. And don't forget to smash the bow. A smashed bow is the pièce de résistance. How's my French in wrapping this crap? Oh, this is really great. Via a group text, Cousin Rich Jr. just sent a video clip he uploaded to YouTube of his two daughters singing We Wish You a Merry Christmas. I'm not going to use ScreenFlow. We're going to point the crappy Sanyo Exacta camera at the crappy Dell monitor. But here you go. This is just brilliant.
We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. The tidings we bring from you and our friends. The tidings for Christmas. In a happy new world. No, yeah. World. Yeah.
So it's a happy new year? Alright.
Oh my god, was that freaking awesome? They're arguing world, no, year, pronounced kind of ear. Good job, girls. Here's my video response to the group text of Rich's daughters singing.
A happy new world, no ear. That's fucking great. And no, Mike, tough shit. You're getting all the text messages.
Yeah, the message to Mike, because he was complaining about getting the group text messages and like, hey, I'm working. Well, tough shit, ho ho ho. Everyone responded back to him, bah humbug. And that you better be in the Christmas spirit when you get to the family party. We'll see. Okay, for Alyssa... I forgot the names. For Alyssa, Gianna, and Vincenzo, they're all older now, so they're getting nice FF class $100 gift cards. Look at that nice trio. But again, we're going to wrap them all together. We're going to put all three in one. But how, pray tell, will we wrap these? So I'm going to offer you something new for 2014. You're going to love this one. We're going to put all three gift cards in a dun, 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 an airport time capsule box. Now, this box is very unique. It's a pretty thick, strong box, and it's really, really hard to freaking open if you don't have a time capsule inside, all right? Because the time capsule, it gives some weight so the bottom comes out. But this is going to be a real ball buster to open, which we enjoy. You see, you thought I was smart. I was going to use a piece of One Direction duct tape to kind of make a handle and pull out the base, but I wound up pushing it down more. So, yeah, this is going to be freaking... God. Okay, so after about 10 minutes of yanking that box, I finally got the base off. I mean, look at this box. This is quite... I mean, look at the technology. God bless Johnny Ives. He probably designs a box. So what we'll do is, let's see if we can put the three gift cards... Yeah, we'll just shove them in here. So basically, when they open this, unless they pull this... The secret base off, they're going to open up an empty box, basically. Come on. Is this good or what? All right, so here we go. Come on. This one-handed action. And I'm working on it, folks. God damn it. All right, I'm going to put the camera down. Well, personally, I think this came out quite lovely. Let me show you. So a little Halloween duct tape to secure the base so it doesn't fall out. And so to Alyssa, Gianna, and Vincenzo from Uncle Alfred, it's a trio of brats time capsule wrap. Now, if you notice, the P is cut off, but look at the detail that I put a little bit of a yellow marker there, a little yellow stain. Why? Technically because it's missing a little P. Look at that detail. And we smashed a freaking bow. Wow, this box is freaking strong. A little bit of One Direction left over. And again, look. Wow, that is art, folks. That is art. This is performance art. This is just beautiful. It's a lovely compact gift. We get rid of three brats in one shot. Oh, something now for Gabriella, my little vortex of evil, who at the age of like 3 years old, when I was knocking at her front door one Halloween night with my white contact lenses and demon, scary ass demon makeup, she looked at me, she stared at me and said, "Can you wear the scary eyes for Christmas?" She since wrote a book, her first book. She wrote a horror story. It's actually pretty good with a twist. I was very impressed. Anyway, for my little vortex of evil, she has toys and everything else. She doesn't need anything. She wanted money because she wants to buy a dress. So the 8-year-old gets a $50 gift card, and I'm going to bundle it with this. A couple of Frozen characters, which, you know, maybe I'll show her how she can, like, melt these in the microwave or something like that. She would enjoy that. Let me try to really wrap this. Well, phase one was to properly secure the gift card to the back of the gift, and now we'll pick some wrapping paper. Okay, so I selected like that little lesbian fairy Tinkerbell paper, and I ripped part of it, so I patched it with some skull duct tape and a little bit of Halloween tape for my little, you know, vortex of evil. To Gabriella from Uncle Alfred, and just the statement that Elsa was an evil witch wrap, because Elsa is inside the box, and we smashed the bow. Smash the bow, smashing all the way. It really does look nice. I mean, my stuff, without any doubt, my stuff really does indeed stand out under the tree. That's part of the reason why I do it. Well, all this gift wrapping and filming has made me incredibly hungry, as it's just about lunchtime. So I am gonna eat some lunch. So I'm not going to the family party like a ravished, raving lunatic eating maniacally over there. All right, let me show you what I'm having for lunch. I'm having my special grilled chicken with black bean and tomato. I don't know what you call it, a casserole or something like that. But you will see the creation of this fine and healthy dish. Well, not the dish, but the contents of the dish in a future FF Class Cooking with Alfred video. So stay tuned for that, and let me know if you can't wait to see it. Rich's daughter, Isabella, had a special request. The product is called Baby Cakes. Sounds like a porn, but let me show you. Yes, Baby Cakes. It's kind of like a George Foreman grill. I said foreskin grill. But it makes like these cake pops. I think that would... Cake pops kind of sounds like... What was that video? Cake farts? Or whatever. Yeah, let's wrap it. Yeah, kind of tucked in there with excess Amazon packaging, kind of like swaddling clothes. Yeah, I like this. Look at this. Yeah. Earth aware. We're very much aware that the earth is fucked from all the pollution. Beautifully framed, a nice Amazon rack. Look, who else puts freaking skulls on a 5-year-old's Christmas gift, but whatever. To Isabella from Uncle Alfred, my suggestion with regard to the device is to use hamburger meat instead. So they'll be like, you know, burger pops, or maybe they should use, I don't know. Let me just smash the bow and get it over with. Angelina requested a specific Lego set. Let me show you. It's the Lego Friends, and they're the friends. So we can do a word joke here. We can nuke the R, make it Lego Fiends, but I think it's better that we just put, we just make them, let's get down there, we'll make it the Lego Hose, all right? Gee, I wonder if they can combine this like with Vincenzo's like Lego robotics kit I got him. That would be kind of funny. You can make little bots out of these witches. All right, let me wrap this. All right, so this gift, not JPEG, is getting a ball mark wrap. This is pretty simple. Let me just doctor it up a bit. So the key here for wrapping this gift for the 4-year-old is to use like an industrial stapler, STAPLA gun. Shout out to you, Alex in Colorado. I did it. I had my finger back there, and I stapled my freaking finger. Well, I did wipe the blood off, at least. I was going to leave a little on for texture, but there it is. Boy, that looks like shit for the four-year-old. To Angelina from Uncle Alfred, don't lose the pieces. The original label said Lego Fiends or Lego Hose, but I didn't think it would be appropriate for the four-year-old. That's like a booger on my finger now. Eh. Oh, I did edit it to say, go crow. I don't know, maybe that's equivalent to, like, you know, go jump in a lake or yeah, go crow. I'll let the kids figure it out. Or they can make it mean whatever they want. It's a universal phrase. There you go. Well, Dave the Marine got a new fancy schmancy FF class 3D smart TV. So I got him a couple of Blu-rays, BLEW-ray. I did get him a couple of 3D Blu-ray porn, but his wife made me send it back, so I got him these instead. How can you go wrong? Guardians of the Galaxy. I really love this movie. And Captain America Winter Soldier. This was actually excellent. And I gotta tell you something. If you didn't see the Lego movie, I was really very impressed. It was a great film, so highly recommended. Let me wrap this shit. Look, I think this crap does look nice. And since I'm recycling, technically it truly is green, eco-friendly. Today from Alfred, blue, spelled BLEW-RAY, RAYS, as requested. And there you go. Little Julian, God bless him, he's into science, and regarding the Thomas Dolby song, we say, science! So let me show you what I got him. I got him this a crystal meth growing kit, And fun with magnets, and I made sure to keep this on top of the Mac Pro in close proximity to the RAID array. Hooray! Now, Julian is a classy kid. He's about like 7 or 8 years old, and he's already hitting on the ladies, so we're going to wrap his gifts in this. A nice Armani Exchange bag, and I certainly enjoy the Armani Exchange products. How do we wrap it? We just throw the freaking boxes in the bag, and it's pretty much done. To Julian from Uncle Alfred, a crystal meth and HD hard drive erase kit. Look at this bow job. It's a bent bow job. And I just realized, boy, these staples, if you look at them, they're really sharp. So if the children are playing under the tree, you better watch out. Look at this, though, and a functional handle. Is that beautiful or what? And we're recycling, folks. Save the planet! Save the Earth! Save the clock tower. Well, I got a nice FF class gift for Rich Sr., who's hosting Christmas Eve once again, and it's a lot of work. And I'm really very, very thankful that Cousin Rich is doing this with a big group of people. But let me show you what I got him. From Grace Digital, it's the new FF class Grace Digital Wi-Fi Internet Radio. This is a really, really cool device. Let me show you mine. So there's mine. This is a different model, and I got this as a gift from the DeFranco family last year, and I really, really enjoy this. And it gets Pandorum and Sirius and internet radio stations, and I tether mine to the Bose clock radio. And what's that expression my nephew Mike Mack told me? No highs and no lows. It must be Bose. But yeah, so this is a fantastic combo. And this model must be a newer model, but this one has a pair of stereo speakers and just, I guess, a larger and a little bit of a more enhanced sound system. Like I said, mine is tethered to the Bose. The way mine sounds stock is okay, but with the Bose, it's incredible. And I'm sure this model with the dual speakers is incredible too. So let's wrap it. Now, who am I kidding? Wrap, whatever. I'm just throwing it back in the freaking box it came in. Done. Nothing but the best for Rich Sr. We definitely had to pull out the Justin Bieber duct tape, and I'm running kind of low on that. And so to Rich Sr. from Alfred, and I say, because it's Grace Digital, I say, Grace, the Lord's Prayer. And with that phrase, you have to think of the movie Christmas Vacation, when they're trying to tell the aunt to say grace during the dinner table. And she's like, Grace, didn't Grace die? And then he goes, the husband goes, no, Grace, the Lord's Prayer. What a great movie. Don't forget to smash the freaking bow. Bow job. Well, I asked the youngest family member down here in South Florida, little Olivia. She's only 2. I said, Olivia, sweetheart, what do you want for Christmas? And she replied, a purple octopus. And I was sitting next to her father, Dave the Marine, and Dave was like, was a little shocked and looks at his daughter and says, Olivia, do you even know what an octopus is? Be that as it may. No, it's not me, it's December. I found a little purple octopus with the plastic choking hazard and all. Whatever. And then I found her another octopus that I guess is like semi-evil. I mean, that's not the picture of what's in the box. That's like a generic picture. But it, yeah, it's kind of like semi-skull-like. And I'm also looking at some stickers that say, like, you know, warning, this is not a toy, not suitable for children under the age of 12 without adult supervision. As such, onus on the parents for the kid not to choke. And there's the finished product for the two-year-old to Olivia from Uncle Alfred with a clear message warning. Choking hazard, all right? And in this case, the iconic duct tape with the skulls, I mean, it really, really does make sense. Now, would you give that to a two-year-old in your family? Most of you would probably say nay, nay, but I think it's lovely. For Dave's daughter, Madeline, some 3DS games, Frozen Olaf's Request and Angry Birds, and for Madeline's sister, for the 3DS, a Luigi's Mansion and a Super Smash. Nice. Okay, and here's a final product to the two sisters. A pair of Nintendo 3DS games for each of them, but look at how I label it, all right? To Madeline from Uncle Alfred, with the message, don't share, fight. And the same thing to her sister, Sabrina. Don't share, fight. So hopefully we can promote some good brawling between the two sisters when each of them says, no, I wanted that game. No, I want that game, and whatever. My stockbroker got me a box of Godiva chocolates, and he shipped it in like one of those frozen boxes, you know, temperature controlled with the dry ice. As such, as a stocking stuffer, I thought I'd get this little Olaf doll for a little two-year-old Olivia. We'll shove that bastard in there. I thought it made sense since it's a temperature-controlled box. So there's his coffin wrap. Beautiful. Just simply breathtaking, right? To Olivia from Uncle Alfred, contains one dead frozen Olaf. Well, I'm not lying to the kid. So in this diesel box came these very kick-ass diesel kicks, which I really enjoy. But I saved the box for senior family member Nancy, Rich Senior's mother, for her precious moments piece. Let's take a look at it. It's Elvis Presley, or at least I think it's Elvis. Yeah, it's Elvis. And it's the precious moments, taking care of business. I think it would have been more apropos if it was taking care of business, showing the more robust, obese, morbidly obese Elvis sitting on the toilet. But be that as it may, this is real nice, and we're going to put, like, good industrial duct tape so it's difficult for Nancy to open like I've been doing for, like, the past 10 years. And yes, for Nancy, with her 87-year-old arthritic hands, we break out the Gorilla duct tape. Final product. To Nancy from Alfred, it is indeed an arthritis wrap. And let's see that industrial duct tape. Yeah, that Gorilla stuff is really strong. She's gonna have a tough time with this one. And for those that have been following the videos for a long time, a senior family member, Aunt Fran, my godmother, she did pass away earlier in the year. I do miss her dearly, but she had a good run to 85. And a brief moment of silence to you, Aunt Fran. You're always in my heart and in my mind. And technically, if you're in my heart, that means from beyond, you're turned into cholesterol, I guess. Whatever. And this is for cousin-in-law Tom, who just moved down to lovely South Florida. I wear this as well, the Acqua di Gio. It's real nice. It's an eau de toilet. Toilet has like a negative connotation with regard to smelling good, at least in my home. But I'm just going to put it in a GameStop bag. Let's see how that will look. I don't believe I had the balls to say, let's see how it's going to look. We know how it's going to look. It looks like total dog shit. What did I say? Look like shit wrap. I mean, it's right on the freaking label. Wow, it looks bad, right? And for Rich Senior's wife, Madeline, also hosting the Christmas party, I got her this. Another precious moments piece, because she collects these like her mother-in-law, Nancy. And it's good to see that the folks over at Precious Moments have really updated and modernized their product line. This is called, I'm always my selfie with you. And it shows, I guess, these two little cute lesbian chicks taking a selfie. They're sleeping together on a twin mattress, and it's just adorable. Look at that, a shout out to my sister-in-law, Coupon Karen, who loves Trader Joe's, Trader Blows. I use a Trader Joe's, Trader Blows wrap. So it's to Madeline Sr. from Alfred. It's a Trader Blows wrap. And I'm done. Well, the wrap job for the gang in South Florida is now done. Let's do the official Alfred.tv slow pan shot and look. Let's take a look at what the collective mess looks like. And wowee. Look at the slow pan shot of the wrapped gifts. Now, you know that the gifts are pretty good, but wow. Wow, do they look like total crap. What a way to wreck the tree. What a way to wreck the total festive mood of the family party. Let's step back a bit. Yeah, that looks like shit. What else can I say? Well, that concludes another wrap video. I gotta go get dressed and get my ass to the party because I'm running a little late. Nancy.
Yes.
God bless you. How old are you?
I'm 87.
You look fantastic. I got you a little gift.
Thank you.
I made the special arthritis wrap with the extra heavy duty duct tape.
Oh, I love the tape on there.
It's gonna be hard for your arthritic hands. Let's see those.
Wait, I get a little.
Yeah, you're gonna have a little problem with that. You want me to get a knife?
Yeah,
I'll get you a knife, all right? So, Nancy, it's Elvis. I thought it would make sense if they had him on the toilet. Isn't that how he died? Right? Taking a poop or something?
Awesome!
Let's see how he looks.
Oh, wow.
Isn't that nice?
Wow.
So, Nancy, I know you collect those like crack cocaine. So, yeah, there you go, Nancy. Merry Christmas. And I gotta say, Nancy, it's so nice to have senior family members around with us at such an age, and they're so dynamic. It's a wonderful thing. Mwah. Merry Christmas, I love you. Hey, you just spoke about my video, knock it off.
Welcome to Alfred.tv.